I'm Stewart Bremner, I'm a graphic designer and artist and photographer. I've been a freelance designer for a long time and start of last year I wanted to use my skills to help the independence campaign, and from starting out just doing things for myself, I did the designs for the digital team for Yes Scotland for the second year of the campaign. I guess I've always been a supporter of Scottish independence, even though I probably didn't realise it. I think I gradually came to over a course of years of just becoming aware of just how Scotland is a sort of second class part of the UK. You know, I was actually visiting my girlfriend at the time in Arkansas. She'd been involved with the Obama campaign during these two elections. Her keenness, the way she got involved, inspired me to actually do something similar, and I realised I had a skill set that I could bring into the campaign that would actually be quite useful. Because I saw that there was graphics happening online at the time, and I thought, you know, I can do those better than that. So I just essentially just started to do them for my own benefit and showed them to the Yes Scotland team, and they said, we like what you're doing. And eventually they said, come and work for us. So it was an organic process. You know, I didn't set out to become somebody involved in the centre of the team, but it just happened. The first 8 months of me working a campaign as myself before I joined the team, I was keeping a very straightforward, clean style, similar to the Yes Scotland logo, which was really basic. I had a revelation one day that actually I had no reason to be constrained by such a dull design. And so I essentially started using my interest in design history as a springboard for my work. The first one was Alphonse Mucha. Reed Miles, who was the designer behind the Blue Note Records. Saul Bass, those are two big names. Charles Rennie Mackintosh came into it at times as well. It was anything and everything that I saw, vintage design, all of this kind of came into a mix and was an influence on how I was creating these graphics every single day in the campaign. Originally, when I started creating my designs, I had an idea of sharing them online as posters people could print out and share on Facebook, Twitter, social media stuff. Gradually, it became more about social media, especially when I got picked up by Yes Scotland. It became very focused on the digital world. But I always tried to create extra work that could be downloaded, that could be shared online, and I started creating prints that people could buy and display to, you know, to show their friends and to encourage talking about the debate, because I think we had a long period of time where people weren't talking about things, so having a kind of art piece on your wall that hinted at the Yes campaign, I think helped a lot of people to bring the conversation into their day-to-day lives. There's that feeling that Scotland is represented by women. I can't really explain it, it's just there. The red hair was self-explanatory. It seemed almost, the red hair and green eyes seems like a cliche, but sometimes when you're making something that's political, that you try to get across a clear message, you have to kind of go for those stereotypes because those are the ones that people respond to. So we've got the red hair, the green eyes, you've got the tam o' shanter on her head and the thistle. And of course the saltire that she's actually inside. You know, I'm conscious that when I was at school, I was more or less taught to never speak any Scottish words. And I was never taught any Scottish history or Scottish literature. It was never mentioned. Maybe Burns on one day a year was occasionally talked about, but the rest of the time Scotland didn't exist in my education. But Scotland actually is a country that has got an identity, and I think it was important to establish that identity. Well, I mean, it's established actually to just reinforce it, to say, look, we're modern, we're a country, and these are the things that are our past, but, you know, they're valid. They're not something to be ashamed of. I mean, we all know it was a popular slogan through the campaign, and I just wanted to do my own spin on it. Again, the saltire is in there. We've got some Art Nouveau style, and that is one of the World War II atomic bombs. So, you know, it's making a serious point with some really horrible things in it, I guess. But, you know, it was a big part of the campaign, and a lot of people responded to this quite strongly as well, because it encapsulates an awful lot of what it was we were actually working for. The original one on social media with the logos on it was actually a bit divisive, because some people didn't like the fact that Labour, Lib Dems, the Tories were all involved in it. But I think it was an important point to be made, and it was something that people responded well to, because it made a point that I think a lot of us didn't see very often, which was that every party in Scotland will be working for Scotland when we're independent. That it won't be this tussle of people moving in different directions. I created this one towards the end of the campaign, when I was starting to do a little bit of stuff for the Common Weal. The idea here was just that, as it says, all of us are first. It's a kind of, you know, it's the Common Weal's aim, is that everyone is equally important, that no one person should be treated better than others. And my idea was that everyone's just putting up, you know, everyone's number one. I thought, the no vote happens, we're done. But the mass response of people going, no, we're going to keep working, really, it stunned me. I thought I would be done with this. I thought I wouldn't be making any more graphics. I thought my prints would be done. And instead, it's taken off. I every week now I'm selling these prints. Chris Law approached me, who was the person behind the Spirit of Independence campaign, the fire engine that drove around the country. And he had me design the fire engine from, which included the same design on it. So that also helped to bring that image into the consciousness. The desire for independence is still with us. It's not gone away, and this image, I think, has been really, people have responded to it really strongly. They really kind of feel this is something they want to say. It's really, and it touched me deeply that people still want to use my work to make a statement.